It's military anyway.
It's a military one.
Yeah.
Radiator.
Yeah.
And we think ours are big in the cars, and look at the size
that's
of
right.
them for a little tour of the factory.
Yeah. Yeah, that's all the copper and brass cores.
Yeah.
This is where the core for your monster was made.
Yeah.
Various machines that produce this fin.
Yeah.
We just buy the strip in various widths and coils.
Yeah.
And then stamp it out up and down to what we're using it for.
Okay.
One of the bigger cores being made, the Caterpillar, something like that.
Right.
Yeah. This is an example of making the fin. This is a narrow strip.
Yeah.
Once it goes through the machine, that's what you get. So that's what we call a more modern core. Yours is the what we call the fin and tube core. It's a far more rigid thing.
Right.
If we'd have put this type of core in yours, it would have shook it to bits. This is the machine that does that particular one. Tin.
Yeah.
And once you pack them all together with the copper fins and flux them first and put them in the oven.
Right.
It is air, everything cold and it melts together.
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, there's some heat coming off that. So that's now a radiator that's come out.
And this is the top floor. I put in yours a flat fin.
Oh, right.
So, once it's been in our oven, it's flux first. That fin is soldered to the tube.
Yeah.
And the tube, as I say, have three tins. So you always test the cores.
Right.
The finished cores leak.
So that it, although there's a lot of machinery, it's still a lot of it is hand hand done, isn't
yeah,
it? You know.
It is. Yeah. Yeah, there we go.
You got a good one.
Once you get used to doing it,
yeah.
It's simple.
Yeah, you shouldn't have said that, should you? Look at that. Well done.
That's Jaguar E-Type.
Oh right,
yeah.
Okay.
We press them in either aluminium or brass.
Right.
Because we make aluminium radiators as well as brass radiators. We supplied Jaguar direct.
Yes.
And we supplied Aston Martin, which is highly self-follow.
Right.
Whatever you're working on, you put the appropriate pattern in.
Yeah.
And away you go. And that one there, that's a Jaguar C-Type.
Right.
Lovely pressing, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah. One of the benefits of it, it'll work through the night.
Yeah.
It doesn't cost a cup of tea. It costs a 30 grand, but it's worth its money.
Those are for?
The Jaguar oil tanks today.
Oh yeah.
The
D-type.
The D-type
tank. Oh, the E-type Jaguars.
D-type.
D-type. Oh,
yeah.
D-type.
You cars are making a Spitfire, right? World War II Spitfire. At this point, they're ready to be fluxed and go in the oven, you see. It raises them all together. Two tubes of fin and head of plates.
Right.
And, you know, they're tested afterwards.
Yeah.
They'll stop in stages when they get in the oven.